Hi, it's Yaakov from gypsyandjazz.com. And in this lesson, I want to show you the magic of triads. I remember myself struggling for years about jazz improvisation. You know, I learned in college and I had private teachers and they always taught me to play tensions and superimpose and substitutes. And it was very hard to think on all those things while the chords are moving and I need to create melodies and to play interesting and keep the groove and the time and the sound. And I had, you know, a great experience when I traveled to Europe and play with gypsy guitarists. And then I had an understanding of something that you don't have to think so much. And you can see only simple shapes, simple things, which are the triads. So I will show you now. If we are in the chord C, all right? In the chord C, this is the triad, C, E, and G. And I take the note C and I play it an octave higher. So this is C major. Very nice and very easy. And now there are three inversions for this chord. Here I am starting on the root. You can start here on the third degree. One, two, three. And here is the shape. C, E, G, C, E. E, G, C, E. You can also see it open. E, G, C, E. So there is one shape. Learn it, memorize it. Two shapes, second shape. Okay? And third shape is from the fifth degree. C, D, E, F, G. G. You maybe know this, you know, if you play barre chord, you play chord C, so this is the shape. And this, the shape, is from this chord. And this shape is from this chord, C. So only three shapes. Now try to play over them. And you see C over all the fingerboard. Now if you want to improvise over the chord C. You see it all over. Now I added notes, right? So what are the notes that I'm adding to the triads? It's half tone below the note, the chord tone, the triad. Or one tone above, diatonic, the next note of the scale above. Or on the second string. Or on the third string. Or the fourth. And you can create your vocabulary of sentences. Or, you know, if I play half tone below and tone above, I can do something. So you can play fast, you can play fast. What I want you to understand that everything that I play now, I see only these three shapes. And I don't care that when I play half note below, I get the sharp 11. When I play one note tone above, I get the 13 or the 9 or the sharp 4 or the 4. I don't care about. I care about how it sounds. All of that. Is by seeing the triads. Now, let's take a song. You know, if we take All of Me, it's in the triad. It it's in the next note is E, fifth position. We had C here, we have E here. And then A7, it's over this major triad, so we have E and A. And now it's a minor triad. So let's leave the minor triad for a second and just see how I can play. I play the melody and I add notes from the triad, see how easy and fun it's to do. And if I add chromatic approach or the tones that next to the triad, I can do. Now let's see the minor shapes. D minor, if we had C before, so that way we made it minor. C, C minor. This C became C minor. And this C becomes C minor. Like in this chord, easy. Like in this chord, and here E flat, G, C, E flat. So now an exercise that I give to my students is first to play accompaniment only with triads. So if you will take all of me, you will play the accompaniment like that. All of me. Da 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 da. I just play. Triad shapes. This is E, AM, D, D minor, G, C, E, A, D minor, F, F minor, C, G, C, melody, only on the triad. I start with the melody and slowly, you know, I start to add notes to the triads, but for me it's only triads. Now I can take it further and further away. I can, you know, forget from the melody and play only the notes of the triad. A. See, it's the triad, D minor. I play half tone below, tone above. Some embellishments and, you know, I add notes. But the triad is the building blocks of my playing. And you can create beautiful improvisation if you just master the triad. I have a course about it. And then I teach 7 songs and I teach the songs and how to use the triads and how to create, you know, to master it, to add the chromatic approach, the enclosure, double enclosure. I show a lot of different variations you can add to the triads. You can play half tone approach, enclosures, double enclosure. It's a lot of variations that you can add, but if you can take from this lesson only the thing that you see, the triad, the three shapes, and play accompaniment to a song using these three shapes, and then arpeggiate the triads and play notes only from the triads, and then add notes, and you see that you can take it into to create beautiful solo. Now I strict myself to the triads. It's not how I usually improvise. When I improvise, I have a lot of more things in mind. I flow freely. But now I just wanted you to see that I play only in those shapes. All right, so this is the magic of triads. Don't give it away. It's very important if you want to play jazz, even if it's modern jazz, or in any style or bebop, because if you see the basic triads, you never get lost. You'll get rid of this feeling of where am I, what is the chord. No, you don't need it. And triads is a great answer if you learn to play every song only with triads and then build your own solo over it. Cheers.